Good afternoon everyone. We are here now at the population area of the municipality of Taytay. 300 meters away, the municipal building of Taytay is located. So now we will picture the facts and we will make video about the historic Taytay Port, or we call it Puerta de Santa Isabel, or also known as Port of Taytay. So we will document and let's proceed. So 300 meters away is the, that building is the municipal hall. Legislative building. See the design of the fence. Nice. I like the design. See that in our right side. No, unique, no? So that's the fence of municipal hall. So 400 meters away or 300. You see the remains of Port of Taytay. So we will make video in the surroundings of that port. Santa May Parada. So we'll document. So the dimension, mamaya dito muna tayo. The estimate dimension of port is 60 by 60 meter, the dimension. So it made up of corrals, and the height is, the highest point is 15 meters. So I will read to you the information, background information about the port of Taytay. The historic Taytay Port, or known as the Puerta de Santa Isabel, was built in 1667. So, under the Augustinian Recollect Fathers, the port was used as a military station during the period and named in honor of Spain's Queen Isabella II in the 19th century. This famous remnant was completed on 1738. So I got this information from bigatintourism.com. So that is my source. Taytay is quiet town in the province of Palawan that still bears reminders from Spanish times, like the splendid Taytay Port or the Puerta de Santa Isabel, still standing and keeping a vigilant watch over the town. So we will roam, see, and document what is the port of Taytay. Thank you.
pasok ya.
Geser tenaga pasok ke tengah
ini. Ikut-ikut lah, Pak. So, I will continue. This is the pathway going to the entrance. See that one? This is the port of Taytay. The pathway from the entrance, it almost 60 meter or 50 meter. So this is the entrance. You see that canyon, and it's real. See, 16th century, it was established in 1667. See that one? The hole. See? Pure metal. The diameter is 20 centimeter. And the tip and the base is 30 to 35 centimeter diameter. And the length is 2 meters. See that one? This is used by the military before. So I will read the signage, but it is written in Tagalog. Kutang Santa Isabel Taytay. Unang ipinatayo na yari sa kahoy ng mga misyonerong Recoleto 1667, himpilan ng kampanyang pangkapayapaan ng mga Kastila sa Paragua, Palawan. The name of Palawan before is Paragua. Sa pagsusumikap ni Gobernador Fernando Manuel de Postillo, muling ipinatayo na yari sa bato at may apat na tanggulan na nagpaparangal kina Santo Toribio, San Miguel, San Juan at Santa Isabel noong unang sangkapat ng ika-18 dantaon. Pinangasiwaan ni Don Fernando Vélez de Arce at natapos noong kalagitnaan nang panahon ding iyon, ang kutang ito ay nagsilbing matibay na muog na nagmamatsyag sa mga sasakyang pandagat na pang kalakal at sumasalakay na mga tulisang dagat. If you are going to know about the translation, this one, for those who can't understand our language, the Filipino or the Tagalog, you can message me and I will translate it to English. Okay? So this the upper portion is the word is National Historical Institute, 1993. So this is the entrance. Ah, pwede pumasok? Ah, sige. Mamaya ako ikutin ko muna yung ano. Si that one, antay mo lang ako, ha? So this is the one of the canyon. So heavy, I think. Grabe, very heavy. Heavy. Mga ilang ano kaya yan, kilo, no? Mga dalawang tinulada. Ilan? According to Rene, 8 person cannot be lift up this one. For 8 person. See, the diameter is 20-25. The thickness is 4 centimeter. Very thick. So, see that one. This port is 15 meter. The height is 15 meter. You see? Pure corals. Look. See? It is meticulously cut. I don't know what is the tools to cut this, because at the time, see, no metal tools. I don't know. I mean, not refined tools. So, see. Meter. So the ikutin 60 meter yung ano. See this one. So it is beside on the road. See?
Defense.
I will document. So that is the port of Taytay, facing the ocean. It was meticulously constructed using the pure corals. See that one? It is located in the shoreline, the rocky shoreline. See? So very strategic, because all the sea vessels will be monitored at the time. See that one? A large street there. So let's see if we can go up. We will try. Port Santa Isabel. So the dimension is this one, 60 meter. 60 by 60. Wow. Doon naman sa kabila, ikot tayo. And the dimension of corals, I will estimate in terms of inches. I think this one is 1.5 feet by 2 feet. So this is the block, one block of corals. So see that one? So there are local tourists who visited this place, and of course they wanted to know some information that corresponds to this port of Taytay. So it is strategically located, so they will monitor. Plans that thrives in the wall, and I don't know what kind of plant is that, but mostly fern. So, oh, the other one, see, canyon. We will try if we can. Hello. Oh, come on. See? Tai Tai Bay panorama. So that is Tai Tai Bay panorama. Coral reef of Dinit Island, Tai Tai Bay, Palawan. Moana Island Hotel. Oh, see? Moana. Tai Tai Bay view from Pavilion Pequeño, Tai Tai, Palawan. Tai Tai Bay and Bay and Puerta Santa Isabel de la Paragua. The older name of Palawan, Paragua. This is one of the island located at Tai Tai, Palawan, the Pavilion Island, Grande Island. So that one. And this is Fish Pins, located at Malampaya Sound. And this is the Pangatalan Island Resort, Shark Pit Bay.
Bawal?
Hidden Lagoon Pavilion Grande Island, Apulit Island Resort. Pakiusapan mo raw, pre, mag ano lang tayo, mag document. Mag ano ka lang ng dinar. I-video lang sana namin.
Kung may kwan kayo, may number ka sa tuwing sa office.
Ah.
Hindi kami hintay lang muna kasi baka masita kami.
Ah, oh, sige. Opo, sige po. Ah, sige po, sige po. Oh. Sige po. The caretaker or the management of this port said that please wait for a while so that she can ask permission from the management. We're just taking video for my vlog so that our tourist, if the tourism will open, this is the one area, one tourism site that can be visited. See that? The pot fern and pakpaklawen. Oh, there is CCTV. See? Maybe I will wear my face mask. I will continue the reading. The historic Tai Tai Port, or as the Puerta de Santa Isabel, was built in 1667 under the Augustinian Recollect Fathers. The port was used as a military station during that period and named in honor of, I think this was already read. The port's small chapel and cannons are still intact, so that's I presented to you a while ago. Tai Tai Fort is now under the supervision of the National Museum. How to get there, or how you can go here? Tai Tai can be reached from neighboring El Nido by bus or van. Chartered planes fly directly to El Nido and takes a little more than an hour. Most local major airlines have daily flights to the provincial of Puerto Princesa, then travel over land by bus or van, ferry lines from Manila and other major ports to El Nido. So, see, you can visit this place. So, this is the main entrance where the you know, this place is very historic because 1667, how many decade now? Even apo, sige, salamat. Ah, sige lang po. Ano lang naman kami, social distancing din po.
Kasi wala
pong
ano yung IDF.
Ah, opo, opo. Sige, saglit lang po, i-ano ko lang. Document lang po namin.
Ano po, Tay?
Museo Puerza de Santa Isabel. Oh, sige po. So you see, oh, you know, this is the ano to sa ilalim, may ano din? Ha, sa ilalim? You see, there is a rocks here at the top. See, we can see, we can roam around. So at the center of this port, there is a chapel. I will document that later. See? So you see the design. This is intended for cannon. See, that is the port of Taytay. See, see the design. This is the tower, the remnants of a tower. This is the big one, the big cannon. See that? In every corner there are four watchtower. So this is the big one. The diameter of the tip is 25, and it almost 4 meters in length. And this one I think 40 centimeter in diameter. See? Big cannon. This is one of the 4 watch tower. See that? So this is the design where they can easily see the people. Land, soil, I think there is underground there. We will ask the management if there. So see, so at the center on top that chapel is erected. So the dimension of this chapel is 20 meter by 10, and the height is 13 meter. So this is the chapel. Can I go inside? So see, I think that roof is temporary. I mean, it's not included during the establishment of this fort. Wow, driftwood. See that one? Guide me always, oh Lord. This is the chapel. Cross for those Christian believe, Catholic believe. You see, there is a big hole to hole. That one. Galing, no? Galing, no? Talaga. See? You see the width of the wall? Almost a meter. So, 1, 2.5. The width. You see? Width of the wall. All corals. Width of corals. 2.5 feet. Tara, let's go. We will ask the management if there is a tunnel below. By 10 or see, wow, nice. Thank you po. Ano po ba ito? Mayroon siyang underground?
Wala po.
Ah, wala.
Yan yung parang bato yan dati.
Opo. Mag-oo. Ay, pero yung at that time po, yung mga tao dito lang sa taas, ganun?
Bag.
Ang mga tao dito noon?
Sa... Dito lang sila sa taas, yung mga Kastila.
Oo. Oh, ano yun? Walang building? I mean, walang
may bro? Building ito sila dati. Siyempre sa katagal, 429 po. Years na nakalipas.
Kasi opo.
15 century pa yun.
Oh, okay.
Na sira na yung ano.
Oh.
Tapos nag-iba na yung daanan.
Ah, nag-iba na. Okay. So, in-estimate ko nga po yung kanyang dimension, siguro mga 60 by 60. Sobra, no? Sobra, baka...
Original talaga na rin
ang... Ilan po?
50 feet po.
Ah, 50 feet. Ah, ang taas niya. Opo. Sige po, salamat ma'am. Yun lang po, salamat po.
Na,
salamat po. So, this can be part of Filipino culture. Conquered by Spanish. Spanish, okay. So, maybe at the time, there is a tunnel, no? See? Oh, so, sorry. See that one? Okay. So, this place is surrounded by houses. The height is 50 feet. there. Small one. Okay, that's enough for now, guys. And hope you like my video. Please comment down below for any inquiry. Thank you.